Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Rochester High School. This freshman basketball contest between the Rochester Zebras and the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings. Again, freshman basketball, Tippecanoe Valley actually listing as a C team. I'm Randy Wynn alongside Abby Malco. Good evening, I guess,
good
Abby.
Good evening, yes.
Morning. I'm not used to this stuff already. Rochester High School is the freshman get ready to go here. We'll get the starters for you here in a minute. Tippecanoe Valley in the green. And Rochester in the black and white. On the floor for Tippecanoe Valley will be number 30, Dakota Parker. Number 32, Drew Hartman. 34, Dan Horton. As the shot goes up. And Zebra's going to be called for a quick foul. We'll finish this. 42, Bruce Webster. And 24, Caleb Banda. The starters for Tippecanoe Valley. As the foul that time, I missed who it was on. As the Zebras on defense, we'll get their starters here momentarily. Shot up from Tippecanoe Valley. Good. Drew Hartman with the first points of the contest. Coach Joe McCarter coaching the freshman team for Rochester, assisted by Wade Langley. Zebras with the basketball. Alan Pfeiffer. Dribbles in, draws the defense, and then kicks out. Zebras moving the ball. Ah, travel there on the Zebras on 24, Jacob Good. Jacob, one of the starters. Jeffrey Harold, number 2, the other starter. Alan Pfeiffer, number 20, the starter. 30, Ian Pugh, and 32, Austin Utter. The 5 on the floor for the Zebras. Valley brings the ball up. Zebras knock it loose, but we're going to have a foul.
Almost a turnover, turned into a foul.
Usually loose balls when people diving around, you're going to get a foul.
That or a jump ball, the toss-up sometimes.
Foul that time on Zebras number 24.
Jacob Good.
Jacob picks up his first. Zebras in a man defense. Tippecanoe Valley moving the ball. Trying to get to the big guy underneath. They do Webster.
Turnaround jumper.
Webster with his first 2 points of the game. It's 4-0 Tippecanoe Valley. Zebras kick it out on the drive. Three-pointer on the way. Good.
Ian Pugh.
Nice looking shot for Pugh. And just like that, it's 4-3. Drive and the kick. And another foul on the Zebras. That's going to be their team third.
Foul on Ian Pugh.
Going to have a sub. And that will cause Coach McCarter to bring in Tegan Mars. He'll bring in for Jacob Good. All freshmen for the Rochester team. Tipped out of bounds. Nice defense that time by Tegan.
Good way to start the game when he just comes in.
Yeah. Still in the man. Valley looking to get it in after the. Valley doing a nice job spreading the floor out, bringing everybody out of the paint.
And Pugh battling against Valley's big guy, number 42. Lob pass is open if the Valley guards can get it to 42.
Pfeiffer picks up his foul. So 4 quick fouls on the Zebras. There's a steal on the inbound. Ian Pugh gets the steal. Quickly up the floor are the Zebras. Tegan Mars with it. And it's stolen. Valley brings it across the timeline. And Caleb Bando. Bando, the point guard for Tippecanoe Valley. He'll reset things. Move the ball quickly around. Nice ball movement by Tippecanoe Valley. Trying to get it to the big guy. Anytime you go away, screen away, trying to get somebody else open, but penetrate, kick. There's another steal. Quickly up to Tegan. Tegan's layup up and good.
Rochester takes the lead, first time of the game. Quick turnaround after being down 4-0.
Valley struggled a little bit to get it down low. not looking for the shot out front. There's one on the way. No good, but the big guy, Webster, with a rebound and a putback. No good. Quickly rebounded by the Zebras. Zebras looking to move the ball. There's a foul. And that's going to be on Caleb Bando. Zebras will have it underneath baseline right. Trying to get open, a little miscommunication on what play they were running, it looked like. Down low, tipped away, and another foul.
Kind of a mismatch underneath with 24 on Ian Pugh.
Yeah. And unfortunately, 24 is about 6 inches shorter.
Yep.
And he's going to come over the top every time. And they will, Valley will sub and bring in number 12, Alan Jimenez. And Bando sits down with two quick fouls. Zebras lose the basketball and a turnover on Pfeiffer. Quickly ahead, and it'll go out of bounds. Coach McCarter giving a little instructional advice to slow things down on the offense.
Might help with some turnovers.
Three on the way, short this time by Pugh, rebounded by Webster.
Lots of movement and ball rotation on Valley's side. More outside shots from the Zebras.
Trying to work it down low to the big guy. Come over and help, and he's up and off the glass. Good.
Over the triple team.
Yeah. So 4 points now for Webster. Four of their six. Kick it back out to Pugh. Pugh fakes the three. Now down in the corner. A little ball movement. You would think the Zebras should see this pattern here. Every time they get it to the post, they get a foul.
I think so. Might be a good idea to pound the post for a little while.
I think they called that one on 30, Parker. And the Zebras will also sub. Bring in Carter Hooks. Zebras turnover again. Quickly down the floor's Valley. Pull it back out, fakes a three, goes to the basket. Nice kick out.
Nice kick out, nice shot. Good play by Tippecanoe Valley.
Dan Horton with his first points of the contest. Zebras pull up for a jumper, no good.
Not many to the boards on that play.
Valley now moving the ball around the horn. Set some nice screens, got rolled off, but not able to put it in the hole. Zebras get the rebound and push it up the floor. Quickly up Harold. Here's a three on the way by Utter, no good, but a rebound pulled down by Keegan. Tegan Mars with the rebound. Now Alan Pfeiffer with the basketball, goes to the hole, too hard. Valley with a quick rebound. Now they'll slow it down and bring it up. Under a minute to go here in the first quarter, 8-5, Zebras on top, or excuse me, Valley on top. Valley took an early lead, Zebras came back, and now Valley's put points on as the Zebras can't get it through the net. 30 seconds here to go in the first. What a quick first quarter.
I'd agree so. I was just thinking about no timeouts.
Yeah.
Pretty quick first quarter.
20 seconds, Valley will fire short, and it'll be out of bounds to the Zebras with 18 seconds.
Good effort by 42 to get the ball that's going out of bounds.
Zebras will have the last shot of the quarter to either tie or trail. There's a roll. Tegan with it quickly now to Carter Hooks. He kicks it out to the corner. Nice drive. Layup up and good.
Good move by Utter.
Utter. Almost too quick as it gives Valley a chance to bring it up, but they don't get it past half court. So the end of the first quarter, it's Tippecanoe Valley 8, Rochester 7. Welcome back here, Rochester High School. First quarter is complete, and Zebras trail by one, but first quick quarter there, Abby.
I agree. Good play by Austin Utter at the end of the quarter to put them within one. It's always nice to get a momentum play to start off fresh at the second quarter, just trailing by one.
Thursday night, freshman game here at Rochester High School. Coming up tomorrow night, Friday night, Friday before Christmas, the guys take on North Miami in the JV varsity game. So hopefully when this airs tomorrow, you'll be ready to go for the varsity game.
Girls Zebras. Basketball game.
It's on Saturday morning.
Yep, against North Miami as well, correct?
Correct. As the Zebras start with the ball in the quarter, second quarter, drive the baseline and get a foul on the big man.
And what I wasn't aware of, and as many years back as I can remember, the boys always played Lewis Cass Saturday evening. They had a change of schedule this year.
Yes, they did, and they moved those to Tuesday.
January 30th.
Yes, December 30th.
Yep, that'd be right.
We're not January yet.
I know.
Don't push it quite this far.
I don't want to go back to school yet, so that's a good point.
Zebras will inbound after the kick out of bounds. Still trailing by one here. 5:40 to go here in the first half. Glad you could join us. Rainey Wynn, Abby Malco. Freshman basketball here at Rochester High School. Tippy Valley, Rochester Zebras.
Valley seemed to extend their defense a little bit, more aggressive.
Nice lob over the top. Good help by Valley. Kick out. Carter with a shot, no good. Rebound by the Zebras, up and good. A great job by Pfeiffer with a rebound. He's got his first points of the contest.
And pretty widespread all throughout the Zebras, I think. You don't see just one person bringing the ball up the floor. Everybody has kind of done their own part and shared the roles of the team so far.
Lob into the Webster, the big man for the Vikings, and goes too far over the top and goes out of bounds. So another turnover on Valley. Jacob Good back in the contest, and Jeffrey Harrell sit down for Rochester. 5 minutes to go here in the first half.
If you notice, Rochester's bench not very deep versus Valley's bench. We could almost have another team out there.
So the Zebras will bring it up. Pew with it, now looking to get things started down Pew in the corner. Pfeiffer to Carter. Carter with hooks with the basketball down to Alan Pfeiffer, a nice little spin move. Pfeiffer now has four.
Big, strong move by Alan Pfeiffer.
Full court press put on now by the Zebras. Valley having a little problem with it. Going to have to get it up the court quickly, and almost a 10 count, and the coach,
called
Coach
timeout.
Ritchie, calls a timeout for Timonu Valley. So
save the possession.
4:30 to go. The Zebras now have a lead of 11-8. With the first time out of the contest. We'll be back right after this. Vikings get the timeout just in time before they get a 10-second count. So the Zebra defense pressure, very, very good after the made shot.
Looked like the Vikings were not expecting it. So good job. Good aggression by the Zebras, taking the lead and putting on some pressure to try and force a turnover at their end of the bucket.
So we'll see what the Zebras do after the timeout. They pull it off to at least half court. And the Vikings will get it across.
Man-to-man on both sides of defense tonight.
Like to see that. Sometimes you get into a zone, and that's sometimes known as a lazy man defense.
Yes.
Shot up and rebound put back by Webster. He now has six. And travel. Put it on the floor before you take off. So kind of important.
Yep, that's usually one of the goals we try and accomplish.
Had the right idea, but
shot fake a little too quick.
Yeah.
I might have done that once or twice.
Maybe. Vikings now with the basketball here. Under 4 minutes to go before half. Zebras up by one. Vikings for three off the short front. Webster with a rebound. Put back up and good. Webster.
About a head taller than everybody around him when it comes to down low post position.
Cleaning things up for Vikings. He's got 8 of the 12. Right over the basketball. Now Pew to Hooks. Hooks puts it on the floor, goes to the rim. Nice shot by Carter Hooks.
Very nice shot.
I think it shocked him a little bit. They got the roll to go right over the front of the rim, and the pressure forces a turnover as Valley steps on the sideline. So great defense again by the Zebras. Forces another turnover.
Applying pressure as they make a shot. Last two possessions.
Coach McCarter making some subs. getting some rotation, get some guys some breaks. Since, like you said, the short bench, only two other guys over there.
Two subs, lots of rotations. Try and keep freshest legs that you can.
Zebras with the basketball after the turnover. Utter with the basketball to the hole, to the hoop. No good. Fight for the rebound. Valley has it. Three on the way by the Vikings. No good. Rebound by the shortest guy on the floor.
Yep.
Zebra's not a very good block out there as Dakota Parker got the rebound, but he's no good on the putback, and the Zebra's got that rebound.
Good behind-the-back move by Pfeiffer.
Reset for the Zebras. Alan Pfeiffer with the basketball. The roll to Hooks.
Pick
Hooks
and roll.
To the hole.
Not as lucky as last
time. No good that time. Carlo does steal the basketball.
Great hustle play.
And he's going to be fouled. And it'll be basketball out of bounds underneath the Zebra basketball. And that foul coming against number 32, Drew Hartman, for Timmington Valley. So the Zebras will inbound. Coming out of the game is Webster and Pisek coming in. Michael Pisek for Valley.
Austin Utter.
Another shot. Good. He's got 4 points. Full court pressure after the make again by the Zebras. Get it across this time. Vikings with the basketball. Trailing by three, 15 to 12, two to go in the first half. And big grab down by Pisek. Better block out that second time by the Zebras.
Yes.
As Pisek will pick up his first foul. 1:50 to go here in the first half. Zebras up by three. Shot on the way, but the Zebras no good. Quickly rebounded by Timmington Valley and Caleb Bando. Bando playing with two fouls. Pisek, the move, and no. Be out of bounds to Timmington Valley. Referee called the foul on the floor. On Hooks, Carter Hooks picks up his first.
No shooting fouls yet this game, is that right?
Nope, no shooting fouls yet. Another substitution as Harrell comes back in the game. As Pisek layup up and good.
Roll back behind the defense. Watching the paint dry.
Does he come with the basket? Three on the way, no good by Utter, and a foul coming on Harrell as he tries to go over the top for the rebound, and that's just not going to work.
Mm-mm. Not usually.
Especially when the kid's taller than you.
Yep, seems to be more noticeable that way, unfortunately.
So it'll be a back with Viking basketball, top of the key. Trying to get some guys open for the shot as the big man's out right now. So they're looking for a shooter. 60 seconds to go here in the first half.
Valley holding on for the last shot, possibly. Last shot or a layup?
You act like you've heard that before.
Yeah, maybe once or twice.
Vikings moving the ball nicely right now. Parker with it and stolen by Carter Hooks. Coach McCarter calling to slow it down, and hey, they're going to look for one shot or a layup. Oh, the give and go.
Great pass.
Give and go by Hunter and Jeffrey Good.
Great combination.
Or Jacob Good, I'm sorry.
Good play by the Zebras.
20 seconds here in the first half. Zebras up by three. Vikings could tie it going into the half. 7 seconds. Setting off the screen for the tie. No good, but a rebound put back up and no good.
In and out.
Caleb Badno tried to tie it at half, but just couldn't quite get the bounce. And so at halftime, Zebras lead 17 to 14 here in the freshman game here at Rochester High School. It's halftime. We're back with the third quarter after this. Welcome back here to Rochester High School. We get ready to start the third quarter. Again, Zebras up 17-14. Quick half of basketball, Abby.
Very quick half of basketball. I think a lot of man-to-man. Unfortunately, quite a few turnovers, so they're back and forth up and down the court. But not many rebounds for either side, you know, just give and go on up and down the court. So, yes, very, very quick half.
Yet to shoot a free throw in this contest as well.
A lot of fouls, I feel like, but on the floor fouls. Yeah.
32 launches a three. That is Hartman for Valley. Quickly up the floor. Nice job by the Zebras. As the Zebras quickly up to Tegan Mars with that basket on a quick look from Utter. There's a three-pointer by Hartman. Drew Hartman. He's got 5 points now in this contest. There's a two-point lead for now for the Zebras. Off the screen, Utter, shot up, good.
And quick Austin points Utter in this half versus it seemed to take a while last quarter.
Utter's got 8, and the Zebras with the full court press causes a turnover. Zebras will have it back underneath their own basket.
Baseball pass not quite on the spot.
No. When you do that, you got to make sure the guy's there.
And no other defenders are around him. That's a key.
So the Zebras will have it back underneath their own basket. Into Utter, and we're going to have another foul. As that foul coming on Dan Orton. Orton will pick up his first. Zebras looking to get it inbounded. They do. Nice wide open layup.
Two defenders trailing Tegan Mars as he goes up for the layup.
Tegan now with 6. Floor court press put on by the Zebras. Nice heads up play that time by Caleb Bando. Knocking it off the Zebras.
Worked out pretty nicely.
And Coach McCarter calls off the Dogs. Under 5 to go here in the third. 23-17. Rochester on top. Randy Wayne, Abby Malco, glad you could join us tonight for freshman basketball. Vikings moving the ball. Bando with it now. Bando to Parker. Parker to Hartman, down low, trying to get it down low to the big man, and does. Webster.
Might have been a foul that he broke through, not called, but he made it anyway. As
he's
you
got
see,
10.
Pfeiffer throws up his hands, kind of, I don't know how to defend that.
Webster now has 10, and a foul on Tippecanoe Valley. And Hartman again, so Hartman will pick up his second.
Still a pretty close game, back and forth the whole time, even in the third quarter. No one's quite broke away yet.
Zebras with the basketball after the foul. Shot up by Pugh. No good. Rebounded quickly by Parker.
Shot almost as an afterthought. No one else to pass to.
Yeah.
Might as
picked
well
up the basketball.
It.
Didn't know what else to do with it.
Yep.
Tippecanoe Valley with it. Now top Parker and a travel. Turnover. Tippecanoe Valley. The Zebras will start their rotations of subs with the two guys. And Carter Hooks comes in the contest. A little pressure in the backcourt now by Valley. Broken easily by the Zebras. Utter with the basketball. Gives off to Pfeiffer. Pfeiffer with it. Tries to the hole. Shot up. Too hard. And the Vikings rebound it. Bando to the hole. Kicks back out. Bando with it. He'll reset the offense.
It's almost as if the three-point line is a wall. They don't seem to take many steps in front of it.
Yeah, these freshmen do like their threes. There, kicks it out and draws the foul that time.
Still a foul on the floor?
I'm not sure. I think he called that possibly on Carter Hooks. Webster again, rolls around, finally drops through. Webster's got 12. 12 to 21, 2-point lead still for the Zebras. Just over 3 minutes to go, shot up. And a foul coming on 32, that's gonna be Hartman.
And we have our first shooting foul of the game. 3 minutes left in the third quarter.
Hartman picks up his third, so I imagine he'll be subbed for. But going to the line for the Zebras.
Alan Pfeiffer?
Pfeiffer. He's got 4 points so far. Free throw. Yeah, a little hard.
Sometimes it takes the first one to measure out where the rim is.
So, in the contest is Jimenez going out, is Hartman. And looks like Jeffrey Good getting ready to check in for Pfeiffer after this free throw if he makes it. He didn't. And a foul. Not a Tegan Mars with his first foul. Trying to get the rebound. So Good in, and Pfeiffer sits down. 3-12 in the third. 23-21 Zebras. Vikings looking to tie or take the lead with this possession. Down low to the big guy, Webster. Throws up a shot, no good. Rebounded out by Timmy DeValley. Quickly to Bando. Bando to the hole. Is the referee going to call it on the floor or on the shot?
He tried to get the shot off, and it will be called as a shooting foul.
Nope, we'll call it out of bounds.
Oh.
Yes.
He thought it was a shooting foul. He was standing at the free throw line.
He did. And Austin Utter was called for the foul, his first. So the inbound. Vikings underneath. Finally getting into Bando. Bando in the corner. Run the point. Now off to Parker. Trying to look down low, but not able to get it there. The Zebra defense.
Recognizing that their big man has half their points, putting extra pressure down low on the post.
Parker with it now. Tried to drive the lane, couldn't get anything. Pulls it back out. And Jimenez with a travel. Another Viking turnover. 2:23 in the third. Zebras will bring it across. Harold will bring it across. Jeffrey Harold. Three on the way by Utter, no good. Rebounded by Webster. He'll get it off quickly down the floor to the Vikings. Shot fake, travel. Got to get both feet down on that jump stop.
Yep. Get a little antsy on both sides. Seems to be a while since.
I was going to say, we're kind of stalemate here with scoring-wise. It's
been 23-21 for
a couple minutes here at least. Under two to go here in the third. Zebras with the basketball. Pfeiffer, that looked good. Good to Utter. Utter down the block. Down to a wide open Jeffrey Good, and he misses.
A little too far
under
the basket.
Good, excuse me. Jacob misses. Valley a quick rebound and pulls up. No good. Rebound fought for. Still on the ground.
Rolling around and Zebra basketball.
That's why you play to the whistle.
Yep.
Zebra's quickly with it. To the hole. Pfeiffer off the glass. No good. Rebound fought for. Jacob good. No good again. Rebound still fought for. Jacob has it and he's going to be fouled.
Lots of hands, lots of bodies underneath.
A little too far under the basket, but he does draw the foul. And Jacob Good will go to the line for his first opportunity of points here. First one's on the way. Got the bounce.
Friendly roll.
Called shooter's roll, isn't that? What do they call that?
I wouldn't know. I've just seen it from other people.
So Zebra's up now three with a minute 14. It's Jacob Good with his second free throw. Yeah, that one looked pretty good.
Nothing but net on that one.
Full court press now by the Zebras. Vikings quickly up. Almost stolen. Now down low. And lost out of bounds by Tipping New Valley. Isaac Prater could not catch up with it, and it goes out of bounds. Seconds in the third. Right to the hole, Pfeiffer. Pretty knocked out of his hand, but they're going to call a foul.
Pretty wide open paint for a drive. Not many people crashed
on
defense. Well,
that's nice to see that he's taking that paint as well, taking that lane. Sometimes you get kids that don't want to do that.
Yep, good play.
Allen's able to drive that and get a foul. He'll go to the line for his first free throws. No good. And so a substitution again for Valley. Pasika into the contest. Allen looking for the second free throw. Short again. No arch. Everything was short, but Carter hooks with a rebound down low to Jacob. Jacob shot blocked from behind.
Good look
Teagan
on the
with
pass.
A rebound. Zebras keep it.
Can't be good for Valley to give up that many. And a three.
Three by Allen Pfeiffer.
Second and third chances will get you every time.
Allen Pfeiffer with huge shot up top, and the Vikings call a timeout. 28-21, 39 seconds left in the third. Be right back. Back here at Rochester High School as we out of the timeout by the Timminu Valley Vikings as Zebras crashing the boards on the offensive end and second, third, fourth opportunities. That time it cost them.
Yep, last big possession, I think, when they missed a couple layups and still got the rebound, and then Allen Pfeiffer hits the three.
So the Zebras will come out in the full court presser after the timeout. 39 seconds to go here in the third. 28-21, Zebras. They get it inbounds. Vikings break it easy this time.
Maybe that timeout helped to draw up a play a little bit easier.
Banda with the basketball, 30 seconds to go in the third. Jimenez, shot on the way, no good, rebound fought for. It is, we're gonna have a discussion between the two officials.
Controversial call.
One says one way, one says the other.
It's usually not good when they're pointing opposite directions.
And we're still having a little chat by the officials.
You know, it's so much easier to be an official when you're in the bleachers.
There it is. That's the right call because he did come over the back and knock it out of bounds, so it'll be Zebra basketball. What are you talking about? What do you mean it's easier to see it?
Well,
see the whole floor, especially when you're sitting up out of the way.
I definitely could give some advice to referees every now and then. I'm sure they don't want to listen, but I could help.
Zebras with the basketball. 20 seconds. Excuse me. And a double dribble on Pfeiffer, so it'll turn it back over to Vikings with 15 seconds to go here into the third, trailing by seven. Zebras up 28-21.
We definitely haven't seen many long possessions on either end of the court tonight.
Jimenez with the basketball to Park Prater. Prater three ball, no good. Fought for, pulled down by Pasika. Missed, rebound quickly out, and a shot at the buzzer, no good. Zebras had an opportunity at the buzzer, but no good. And we'll head to the fourth quarter with a 28-21 Zebra lead. Back with the fourth quarter. Back here at Rochester High School, Rainey Wynn, Abby Malco. Glad you could join us for this freshman contest as we head to the fourth quarter. Zebras up seven, Abby, as we head to the fourth.
I think very heads-up play at the end of the third quarter, knowing how much time you had left. They baseball passed the ball as far as they could, and quick release by the Zebras, just a little bit short. But heads-up play as far as time goes with the Zebra basketball team.
So the Zebras will start with the possession and up seven. So now it's the clock is in your favor.
Yes.
We'll see if the Zebras are a little more patient here, maybe looking for shots.
Less threes, more layups.
Yeah.
A little more spread offense.
Ian Pugh with the basketball. Dribbles off of his own teammate's foot as he tries to set a screen and a turnover on the Zebras.
I'm sure that wasn't supposed to happen.
No. So, Valley with the basketball and Bando bringing it up. He'll spot up a three. No good. Quick shot. And the Zebras pull out the rebound. And we'll bring it up the floor. Pfeiffer with the basketball. Gets rid of it. To Pugh. Pugh between trees. And he travels. Oh, 3 second call. So another turnover. And it'll go back to the Vikings. Parker with it to Bando. Vikings trying to move it. It looks like they're trying to get it down low to Webster. Webster's got 12 of the 21 points. I think I'd get it to him too.
That sounds like a good game plan if you're Tippecanoe Valley.
Not able to at the moment. Zebras playing good defense, fronting him. Now there's the good lob, and good for Webster. He's got 14.
And good job by the Zebras to not let the ball get down low, because once he does get the ball, there isn't much they can do about it after that.
Three on the way by
Pfeiffer.
Pfeiffer, no good. Again, time and management right now for the Zebras.
A three may not be the best option.
Bando up and no good. Carter hooks with the rebound. Carter's going to be fouled.
Good aggression by Tippecanoe Valley, just a little too much.
Zebras will sub again and bring in Tegan Mars. Pugh will sit down. 4:29 to go in the contest. Zebras up five. Pfeiffer with the basketball. Pfeiffer down low to Harrell. Harrell's shot up blocked, but he gets his own rebound, and they'll kick it back out and reset the offense.
Good job to stick with the play and not give up.
Zebras flashing players across the paint. That time they tried to get it into Tegan Mars, but he was fouled by Webster, and that'll put the Zebras at the line.
1-1.
For 1-1, where they can add to this lead.
Free throws will be important at this point in the game. 4 minutes left in the fourth quarter.
Mars already has 6 points. Megan,
seven.
Zebras scoring, of the ones that are scoring, fairly even across the board.
They seem to all share kind of the same responsibilities. A lot of them can handle the ball. A lot of them can rebound and score.
Another free throw good by Tegan Mars. Full court presser by the Zebras. Bando. Bando breaks it. Bando to the hole. Stop. Pop. No good. Rebound by Carter Hooks. Quickly outlet to Utter. Utter down the floor. Saves it, but right to Tippecanoe Valley.
Good idea, just a little too far out.
Yeah. All of a sudden, we're getting into a track meet.
Yes.
Good basket that time by Dan Horton for Tippecanoe Valley. He's got two more. That gives him four. Ball's loose, kicked out of bounds. Turnover on the Zebras. Coach McCarter wants a timeout. We'll take one as well. 3:37 to go in the fourth. Zebras up 30-25. After the Zebra timeout, probably a good one on Coach McCarter's part there to settle the freshmen down a little bit.
They look a little tired. Like you said, they had a little bit of a track meet for a couple possessions with Tippecanoe Valley, but they have the lead by 5 points. I think spread out offense, get some layups, and maybe a little less of three-point shots will help the Zebras seal the victory.
So the pressure's off as the Bando will bring it across for the Vikings. Bando now sets, runs the offense. Shot fake into the lane. It's Parker, but he kicks it back out as he doesn't have anything. Bando tried to go down low, stolen by Utter. Utter then stolen by Bando. Pasiga wide open, misses, gets his own rebound, gives it to Webster. Webster's going to go up and make it. Webster's got 16. 3-point contest now with 3 minutes to go. Mars down low to Carter Hooks, wide open, good.
Nice. Two wide open layups in the past two possessions.
Nice look that time by the Zebras. Full court presser again. Bando slips, Keegan picks it up, misses the layup, saved. Utter is going to be called for a foul.
And big call because two Zebra players were underneath the basket with no green shirts near. So it might have been an easy layup for the Zebras if the foul wasn't called.
Again, full court press. Bando with the basketball. Right up the sideline. Nobody puts their foot on the sideline, so he'll bring it all the way up to Pisek. Up and good, a foul.
And that's one thing that can't happen is a foul with a made shot. As a defender, you never want to see the ball go through the hoop and hear the whistle blow.
Pasiga picks up his first. Pfeiffer picks up his second. Masika gets his fourth point at the free throw. He'll be looking for number five.
If he makes this bucket, they will be within one. Two, excuse me.
Free throw. Ooh, a little too hot. Tipped around, fought for, and it'll stay with Tippy New Valley. No over-the-back calls. Fans wanted that one, but 2:35 to go. It's a three-point game. 32-29 Zebras. Webster on the inbounds. Good.
Very nice shot from the baseline. That's 15-footer, tricky shot. Webster does a nice job with that.
He's got 18. And the Zebras throw it away. One-point game. Coach McCarter going to bring back in Pugh. And Pugh will replace Jeffrey Harrell. So Parker and Bando will bring it up. Pugh comes into contest and he'll be guarding Webster now. Bando to the hole. Thrown up, no good. Gets his own rebound. Brings it back out.
Through a lot of commotion. I'm surprised there wasn't a foul call. A lot of hands and arms flailing with that shot.
Vikings looking to score. Take the lead and a turnover on a travel.
If we were keeping turnover stats, it would be interesting to see if they're about even for the night.
Several.
Seems as if we go one way, we head back the other way.
Hartman comes back in. Pasika will sit down.
I think that's supposed to be your partner's job to keep turnovers.
Yeah, usually, but, you know, good help's hard to find sometimes.
I agree.
Hey, I'm just glad you could make it. Another turnover. Bando up and good. Layup.
Puts Valley up. It's been a long time, actually, since Valley's had the lead in this game.
I think so. And Coach McCarter wants a timeout. 33-32, 1:44 to go here in the contest. Zebras, timeout. Back after the timeout, Zebras will have the inbound underneath Valley's basket. Valley coming out now in a full court press. Valley up one. 33-32 with a minute 44 to go. Rainy Wynn, Abby Malco, glad you could join us. Freshman basketball here at Rochester High School.
Valley puts on the press for the first time this competition. The ball's thrown around.
And the Zebras get a timeout just in time.
Do they keep the possession?
They keep the possession. I didn't think there was a possession there, but Coach McCarter able to get a 30-second timeout. And we'll stay here with this 30 as a minute 33 to go. 33-32. Zebras trail now by one. First time they've trailed Abby since early in the first quarter.
I think you're correct.
Coach McCarter saving the ball that time as possession arrow is with Tippecanoe New Valley, so a good call there to get the timeout. And the basket looks like it's going to be either just shy of the sideline of the bench, but or underneath. I'm not quite sure where the official is going to put it in at.
Every possession important from now on. 1 minute 33 left. Take care of the ball, make your free throws, but close game no matter what.
Then you got to also remember it's just a 1-point game, so you don't need a three at this point yet. Two will work just as well. Harrell to inbound, does so to Utter. Utter with the basketball. Now to Pfeiffer. Utter's calling for a screen. Pfeiffer rolls with it, out to Harrell. Back to Pfeiffer. Nice fake with Utter, but he airballs out and it goes out of bounds. It'll be Valley basketball.
Someone took a hard tumble, I heard.
And Valley wants a timeout. 33-32, 1:16 to go in the contest. We'll be back. Back at Rochester High School, freshman basketball, fourth quarter, 1:16 to go in the fourth, 33-32. Tippecanoe New Valley with the lead and the basketball going the length of the court. Full court press again by the Zebras. Vikings do finally get it in about the four count.
That was very close. I was waiting for the whistle to be blown.
In the backcourt, not moving the ball forward. Hartman with it. That gets it across, but stolen by the Zebras.
Oh.
Quick lead pass. Sloppy basketball right now on both sides.
Yes.
Under a minute to go. And a foul coming on Pfeiffer.
It will come down to who can make their free throws, I have a feeling.
And still be out of bounds because the Zebras not, or Vikings not in the bonus, not till the next one. Bando with the basketball. Bando to the hole, kicks out, fakes the three, and then it'll bring it back out to Bando. To Parker, and he's going to be fouled by Pfeiffer. So that's going to send Dakota Parker to the free throw line for 1-1. 45.6 seconds to go in the contest. Vikings up one with a 1-1 by Parker. Eyes it, flies it. Hard off the back of the rim. Rebound fought for. Zebras had it. And Tegan Mars and Carter Hooks both came down with it and tipped it out of each other's hands. It'll go out of bounds to Valley.
Big possession the Zebras did not want to lose.
Inbound to Webster. His shot up and no good. Fought for by the Vikings. Horton. And Vikings kick it back out. 34 seconds.
If I'm the Vikings, I try and hold on for 30
Pfeiffer
more seconds.
We'll finally get a foul on Drew Hartman. Pfeiffer fouls out of the contest. Alan Pfeiffer picked up his fifth foul. And Coach McCarter will go to the bench with either Pugh or Good. We'll wait and see who he brings in. And it's going to be Pugh. Ian Pugh will come in for Pfeiffer. 31.3 seconds to go. Vikings still up one with another 1-1. So at the line will be Drew Hartman. Trying to add to this Viking lead. Free throw, no good. A long rebound fought for. And Vikings get a timeout. Vikings get a timeout, 33-32, 28.6 seconds to go in the fourth. Back after this. Back here at Rochester High School, 28.6 seconds to go. The last 30 seconds have been kind of helter-skelter.
Helter-skelter, that's the exact word that popped into my head. Back and forth, and not in anyone's favor, just whoever can get the loose ball on the ground, it seems to be.
Vikings inbound, and Bando is fouled right away by either Mars or Pugh. Sure who he called it on, but the Vikings will go to the line for 1-1. Caleb Bando, 2 points on the night. Trying to add to this. Vikings, this will be their third 1-1 and have missed on the front end of all three of them. Finally, the Zebras pull down the rebound. Pugh with the basketball, 25 seconds. Pugh to the hole, up and no good. And are they going to call it on the shot, or are they going to give him the 1-1? He's going to shoot free throws either way.
Good attack. He saw the hole. They crashed quickly, but good job to get a shot up. If he makes them both, they can take the lead. Might be best not to look at the scoreboard in this situation. Just hit your free throws.
Free throw for Pugh.
Little controversy between on the floor and a shooting foul.
They could call it on the floor. So that makes it even bigger here for this first one. Good. Pugh good with all the controversy going on.
Great shot.
Says I'll fix that problem. Just make the first one.
Just make it and everybody will be quiet.
Tie ball game. 20.9 seconds.
This free throw can put the Zebras in the lead.
Free throw, no good. Rebound fought for on the ground. And the Zebras come down with it and get the timeout.
Great call by Coach McCarter. Huge play by Tegan Mars to grab the loose ball, and great way to keep the possession by calling a timeout.
It's just a 30-second timeout, so Coach McCarter will draw up a play here with 17.7 seconds. Tie ball game. And the basketball will be inbounded baseline right for the Zebras underneath their own basket.
Try and get a layup. And if you don't get a layup, I'm assuming a foul will be coming from the Valley Vikings.
At this point, yeah, I think you want to look for that layup underneath. I think you've got a better shot of drawing the foul.
Maybe an and one.
Than kicking it out too far. So we'll see what the Zebras do. Harrell will inbound. Zebras will stack it up on this near side.
Maybe stack it up.
Throws up a three, no good, rebound. No, and a foul with 14 seconds to go on the miss, and the Tippecanoe Valley back to the free throw line.
Probably not what the Zebras had planned in the timeout.
No, actually it was a pretty quick shot.
Yeah.
There was 17 seconds and there's still 14, so didn't really gain a whole lot with that quick shot. Now
right.
The Zebras find themselves with a 1-1 here for Tippy Valley. Missed. Oh, two-shot foul, excuse me. Misses the first one. Dan Horton, the free throw shooter, missed the first one. Still tied. 14 seconds to go. Second one on the way. Hard again. Rebound, Tegan Mars. Tegan Mars throws it up to Harold and stolen by Tippecanoe Valley. And utter fouls with 10 seconds to go. Fouls Webster. So Bryce Webster will go to the line. And that's five on Utter. So Coach McCarter has to go back to his bench for his last player.
And I don't think the foul was in the game plan as Coach McCarter's reaction.
Yeah.
Tie ball game, just let them.
So Utter fouls out. Pfeiffer has fouled out, so the Zebras have no subs left. So Webster, who already has 18 points, misses the first one. Nobody wants to hit a free throw to win this thing.
Nobody would like to, no. Pugh hit two of his free throws and then threw up a three. But other than that, I don't think I've seen many made free throws.
Webster again misses that one. Zebras pull down the rebound. 8 seconds. Quickly up the floor of the Zebras with five. Down low to Harold. Harold throws up. He's going to be fouled. Call a foul on Webster with 1.5 seconds to go. That'll send Jeffrey Harold.
And both sides of the stands erupting. Rochester happy for the foul call. Valley extremely unhappy. I think they thought it was close enough to a block.
Two shots. I think Webster thought it was a block, too.
But I think, too, when you put yourself in that position, it's the referees have the whistle.
Yep.
You give them the choice to choose.
First shot on the way. Good.
And that might have been the basketball
game. Harold's first point of the contest comes at a crucial 1.5 seconds left. Coach McCarter reminded them, no fouls.
1.5 seconds, I would stay back.
Harold's second shot. Good. And we have a timeout. Tippecanoe Valley will take their final timeout. 1.5 seconds to go. Zebras up two. We'll be back with a final 1.5 after this. 1.5 to go here in the contest. 35-33. Zebras on top after Jeffrey Harold's two made free throws. Boy, this last 30 seconds has taken a long time.
As fast as the game went, I think these last 30 seconds have taken up the rest of the time. But you asked if anybody was going to make a free throw, and Harold stepped up and did the job.
Finally did. So the Zebras just putting a little pressure on just to take away the 1.5 seconds. They throw it up. Bando with the basketball. Bando fire a three, and it's off the mark, and the Zebras
win a
come
very
back
close
from down. They were up, then they were down, and a back hard fight. The last 2 minutes here was it was up for anybody's basketball.
Yep.
Finally, the Zebras settled down. Jeffrey Harold hit two free throws to win the contest for the Zebras here tonight, 35-33 over Tippecanoe Valley. And great game for everybody. And glad you could join us. Abby, thanks for joining me tonight.
Thank you.
Freshman basketball here at Rochester High School for RTC-TV. Glad you could join us. And get out and support these kids as anytime they're at home, because these are all of boys, girls, they're putting in a lot of effort. So get out and enjoy it. And,
absolutely.
And get out and cheer them on. So thanks for watching RTC-TV.